Setting up a database for your Replit app used to be hard, but in this tutorial, I am going to show you how to implement it simply using Replit Agents. To get started with databases, I'm going to create an application that tracks what trainers I have in my wardrobe. So I need to prompt Replit to create an application that tracks the trainers I have. We have our prompt written, and now we're going to click Start Building. Replit has devised a plan for sneaker inventory, and we want to approve that plan and start. Replit has now finished our application and it's added a collection overview, it's added a statistics tab, and it's added a settings tab for us, which is really cool. What we want to do is add a database. So currently it doesn't necessarily have a database, I don't believe. And what we're going to do is go to database. And in database, it allows us to hit the button to create a database. And this is a fully managed database where we get charged based on usage. So that is perfect for us and our growing application. We're going to hit create a database. Now we've created a database, but we don't have any data and we don't have any data schemas. So we can go to my data and see there's no tables here. And what we're going to do is prompt Replit to create our tables for our application, because as you can see, it has the front end to store sneakers, to store sneaker value, to store information for what's most worn. And we want all of this information to be stored in our database. Now Replit has created database schemas for users, sneakers, and settings, and implemented the database connections, created tables, and fix the API endpoints to work with the databases. If we go and visit the database tab, we can see that we have a few different types of tables. We have sneakers, we have settings, we have a users table, and we can dive deeper by clicking my data. Obviously, there's nothing there right now. Same with sneakers, same with users, but we will add something in a second just to see how it uploads and how it works. We can see that we have our columns and our rows of data. If we wanted to add another column, all we had to do is click X and we can add it manually, or we can just prompt it to add another column. By using the buttons here, we can filter data based on different properties. We can also add and remove columns in the view. If we go to commands, we can see information to connect other applications to our database if we wanted to connect other applications to our database. Lastly, in settings, we can restore our database to a previous point in history and also choose to retain the history of changes up to a certain period of time. Let's go ahead and add a sneaker just to see what this looks like. So if I click add sneaker, we're going to add Jordan, and we hit add sneaker. And even though the image I use is not a recognized format image, we can see that it has uploaded our sneaker. But more importantly, when we go to database and we go to sneakers, we can see that we now have our sneaker in our database. So that's it when it comes to your basic overview of Replit databases. With a couple of prompts, it's easy to get started with your next big application. Thanks for watching. Be sure to check the link in the description to go to No Code MBA, a learning platform with dozens of in-depth, high-quality courses on no-code and AI taught by industry experts. And be sure to subscribe to our channel here to get more free content on YouTube.